So good morning, everyone. Let us start our discussion on this NTTB agent. So in the last class, we discussed what are the various types of the TB, the general introduction to TB, that what can be the impact of TB on economy, on human health, etc. All these things we have discussed in the previous lectures. After that, we also have seen that classification of NTTB drugs or classification of NTTB currently used NTTB drugs. So in this, we have seen there are basically two ways these drugs can be classified. Number one, that is first line NTTB drugs. And secondly, it is second line NTTB drugs. So depending upon the chances of the resistance, depending upon their efficacy and the level of the treatment, these drugs are classified. The first line drugs, isoniazid, rifampicin, pyrazinamide, ethambutol, and streptomycin. So these are the drugs which are covered under first line NTTB agents or first line NTTB drugs. So these drugs are less vulnerable for resistance. The chances for development of the resistance for such NTTB drug is very less. Okay. And after that, we also have seen some of the examples of first-line drugs such as isoniazid, which is a isonicotinyl hydrazide derivative, and it is basically INHA enzyme inhibitor. So we have also seen the classification for this. Sorry, and its mechanism of action, the side effects we have also seen. It will undergo metabolism by the way of N-acetylation for this. So there are two types of acetylations way it is there: slow acetylators and fast acetylators. So slow acetylators will develop a side effect called peripheral neuropathy. So that's why whenever isoniazid is given to a patient, it is suggested that a supplement of vitamin B6 has to be given to such NTTB patients. After that, we also have seen another drug such as rifampicin. So rifampicin is basically a macrocyclic antibiotic. So basically obtained from Streptomyces mediterranei. This drug is effective on acting against RNA-dependent RNA polymerase enzyme, abbreviated as RDRP. But side effect with this drug is that whenever it is injected to the patient, given to the patients, it will cause discoloration of body fluids of the patients. And these body fluids are generally, let me say, lacrimal fluids, salivary fluids, and urine. So these things, it may cause some uneasiness in the patients. That orange or red tint type of discoloration of such excretory or other body fluids may be observed, because it is a dye. Naturally, it is a chemical which can cause discoloration of such body fluids. The third drug after this we have seen, that is ethambutol, which is a completely aliphatic moiety. Not a single aromatic ring is present into that. Pyrazinamide is pyridine derivative. That is a pyrazine derivative, so that we will see today. But this ethambutol, which is having stereoisomeric structures, there are two chiral centers into its structure. So there are four isomers can be possible following the Wontoff's law of stereochemistry, 2:2. So friends, this pyrazinamide, ethambutol, and rifampicin, all the drugs are having including isoniazid also. Ethambutol mein hepatotoxicity nahi bola hai. It is does not cause hepatotoxicity, but rest of these NTTB drugs can cause hepatotoxicity, including isoniazid, pyrazinamide, and this rifampin, rifampicin, or rifapentine. So these are rifampin class of drugs. Rifabutin is also this, belongs to rifamycin class of drugs. And this, if you see the structure of rifampicin, then it is called as ensamycin. It is called ensamycin. Because if you see the structure of rifampin, then you will come to know that this is a drug which is holding aromatic moiety such as benzene derivative or substitutions likewise that. In that is a kind of holding way. So I can present to you people in that this way. Let us say, let me show that to you. Yeah. So here you can see the structure of rifampicin. All these are called as ensamycins. Or why they are called as ensamycin? Because you can see this is a naphthalene ring, which is aromatic in nature. And this is holded by this aliphatic fragment. Right? So it is a completely cyclic ring starting from this way. So basically it is a cyclic, but it looks like that this aromatic ring is holded by the two ends of aliphatic portions. So this is basically aromatic ring, the naphthalene one, and this is called aliphatic portion. So that's why this bis naphthol bol sakte hain, because it is having two hydroxyl groups which are present on every on this naphthalene ring. So that's why this rifampin or rifampicin is called as ensamycin. Ensamycin kind of antibiotic. I'm not sure whether it is there or not. These are the compounds which are termed as ensamycins. So there may be some question that for why such drugs are called like ensamycin, because they possess naphthoquinone, which is holded by aliphatic ENSA chain. ENSA is the name of this aliphatic chain. This chain. So that's why it is termed as ensamycin. So rifampicin is called as ensamycin. We didn't discuss in the last lecture, so that's why I took a chance to discuss this rifampicin with you people, that it is also called as ensamycin. So majority of the three drugs we have seen in the last class. Now today onwards we will go for some additional drugs and their to complete this classification of NTTB drugs. Okay, so in this category we have seen all these introductions and up to this. So today we will meet a new first line drug, that is pyrazinamide. So as you can see, this is pyrazinamide, which is having pyrazine ring. This ring is termed as 1,4-diazobenzene. That is called as pyrazine. So pyrazine is this NTTB drug, right? Pyrazine is the moiety which is present in such NTTB drug. Okay. Now this is a basic similar molecule, just like to isoniazide. Isoniazide or iske structure mein zyada fark nahi hai, only we are having this nitrogen. Iso, and here isoniazide was having NH2. If we go back to some of the previous slides to see the structure of isoniazide, so here it is. This is isoniazide. It is having aromatic ring, but that is 1-azobenzene. Pyridine is the scaffold which is present in isoniazide. That also possesses carboxamide, CONH. Here it is hydrazide. It is amide using hydrazine. Hydrazine is ko bolte hai. NH2. Okay. So that's why this can be NTTB drug or uska hi very closely similar structure, that is this pyrazinamide, right? Only addition of one nitrogen. Yahan pe nitrogen side chain mein tha, ab wo nitrogen aromatic ring ka part hai. Already both the drugs are three nitrogens, isoniazide as well as pyrazinamide. Once the structure is changed, so again the drug is that. This is also weakly tuberculocidal, means weak. It is not as much as good as isoniazide, but relatively having some bactericidal actions against mycobacterium tuberculosis. Okay, and that is more active in acidic medium, and these are some of the other things. It is also inhibiting the mycolic acid synthesis inhibitor, cell wall synthesis inhibition in Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Yes, this drug is given orally and it is having good per penetration in cerebrospinal fluid, having some also metabolized in liver and urine, and that is having plasma half-life 60. So that is sufficient, 6 to 10 hours means if raat ko ek goli le lo to fir agle 10 ghanta tak to chalegi, 6 se 10 ghanta, depending upon the age of the patient. Okay, so this drug can be given just, I mean to say, it may be twice in a day because its half life is near about 12 hours. I'm not telling for 13, telling perfectly 10, perfectly 12. Adverse effect. This is a drug which is associated with metabolism of uric acid. So it can cause hyperuricemia. Bolo, now can any one of you tell me what is hyperuricemia and in which pathogenic disorder it can be observed? Yeah, question to all of you. Yes.
Gout.
Correctly. This is a drug which can cause gout. एक तो already TB था patient का, उसको आपने एक ऐसी दवाई दी तो TB उसको gout हो गया. पहले तो वो थोड़ा ठीक ठाक चल पाता था, अब वो चल ही नहीं पा रहा. So this is a side effect of this anti-TB drug. First line anti-TB drug. Right? And it can also cause hepatotoxicity, just I have mentioned today. And some other side effects such as abdominal distress, arthralgia, pain in the joints, that is called arthralgia, flushing, redness, fever, loss of diabetic control. And whenever two DCs are mixed, it is really difficult to give to treat the patient. Diabetes be or TB be over. So look, complications are severe. TBB or HIV AIDS, then it is perfectly gone. That patient is really difficult to treat. The patient is already taking antiviral drugs, then anti-TB drugs. Anti-TB mein toh already 10-12 goli hai. Usko toh har din, do din khani padti hai. So that is a challenge to treat such patients. Isliye the mortality rates, the number of deaths are much higher in the patient of TB co-infected with HIV. HIV be or TB be, then that patient is about to die. And it is difficult to treat for the doctors as well by giving certain medications, etc. Right? So next, another class of first line anti-TB drug, that is this antibiotic, streptomycin. It is obtained from some streptomycin bacteria. And remember the difference. Dr. Sureja might have taught you this thing. What is called antibiotic, what is called antibacterial agent. So both are different from each other. Antibiotics are the one which are obtained from mycobacteria, from bacteria, from fungus, from viruses. Right? You know the very well the perfect example for penicillin, which is antibiotic obtained from Penicillin chrysogenum, discovered by the scientist Sir Alexander Fleming. Flory and the chain, these are the two scientists who could synthesize this antibiotic in bulk. So antibiotics are always produced by microorganisms, can be virus, bacteria, fungus, or pathogens. Fine. But it is completely different from antibacterial agents. Your sulfonamides, which are antibacterial agents, none of the bacteria produces sulfonamides. I repeat, none of the bacteria produces sulfonamides. Sulfonamides are the agents which we have synthesized in our lab. I mean to say, which could be synthesized in the lab. Prontosil rubrum, which was first identified by the scientist Gerhard Domek. And you know sulfonamides, which are acting on folic acid metabolisms. Right, so there are several sulfonamides, sulfomethoxazole, sulfapyridine, sulfamethazine, sulfapyrazine, etc., etc. They are available and they are termed as antibacterial agents. This molecule, which are in of our interest as first line anti-TB drug, the structure is on your present screen. You can see it is a sugar moiety here. Exose sugar is present into that. Okay. Although it is somehow amine is attached, so maybe glucosamine structure. Another furan ring, which is having some other this structure into that, and also a sugar ring is present. This is not sugar ring. This is only cyclohexane ring. This is a sugar ring because it is having pyran. We'll say this pyran ring is present into that structure. Maybe hexahydropyran or tetrahydropyran. Okay, so this is a structure of streptomycin, which is an antibiotic obtained from streptomyces bacteria. Okay, and it is also tuberculocidal. It can kill Mycobacterium tuberculosis, and it can penetrate this cerebrospinal and enter into tubercular cavities, but does not cross this blood-brain barrier or cerebrospinal fluid. Okay. And it is given by intramuscular injections. It is not given by orally, it is given by intramuscular injection. But it is a aminoglycoside antibiotic. You can see this is amino sugar, aminoglycoside. And all the aminoglycosides are having ototoxicity. They can cause damage to the ear. They can cause damage to nephrotoxicity. Fine. These are the major side effects of the first-line anti-TB drug, streptomyces. Pyrazinamide can cause gout. Streptomyces can cause ototoxicity and nephrotoxicity. Patient who is given this drug may have loss of hearing capacity, or its kidney function may be lost because of kidney failure. So this is aminoglycoside. This isoniazid can cause hepatotoxicity and peripheral neuropathy. This then rifampicin can cause discoloration of body fluids. So that is another side effect. Hepatotoxicity beer. Ethambutol, hepatotoxicity nahi hai, but it is having other side effect. Right? So these are the major drugs having side effects. And this is a drug is only given for only 2 months because we cannot afford this drug to give as a first line supplemental and first line anti-TB drug. The reason is if it is given to the patient, to already patient ko TB tha, to sunne ki shakti bhi uski chali jayegi. Or kidney function loss ho gaya, to fir he can person survival of the TB patient will be more dangerous. That's why this drug cannot be given more than 2 months. Its use is restricted only for use up to maximum 2 months. These are the limitations of first line anti-TB drugs. So although they have less chances of the resistance, they have side effects. The DOTS therapy, directly observed treatment short course, is the therapy which is given to the patients for 6 months. So patient ka TB hai aur ye dawai hum denge, so patient will lose his kidney, will lose his ear, will lose the liver, will function lose, we will, it will, he or she will lose the functioning of these organs, right? Aur usi mein TB ke sath fir HIV AIDS ka infection ho gaya, to fir patient gaya kaam se. This is a really a challenge to treat tuberculosis. After first line drugs, some of the second line drugs are also given as anti-TB drugs. So friends, this, what are the second line anti-TB drugs? Second line anti-TB drugs are the one which are maybe less efficacious than first line drugs, but they are having more chances of development of resistance. Risk of development of resistance is higher for these drugs. And I hope that you people know the meaning of resistance. Mycobacteria is having complex genomic structure. And this moment we identify any new molecule to kill the or to inhibit particular one enzyme, then it will develop another alternative pathway to meet the demands of the body cells of or the cellular needs of Mycobacterium tuberculosis. For example, if I say you people want to reach from LMCP to, let us say, Qutub Minar, New Delhi, or Agra, as a Taj Mahal, if you want to go from LMCP to Taj Mahal, you can go by road, you can go by foot, or you can go by air as well. Okay. So if we inhibit, let us say, these three options, आप फुट बाय रोड भी आप नहीं जा सकते हो, बाय सेल्फ ड्राइव भी आप करके हम वी विल लेट अस लॉकडाउन हो गया और आप नहीं जा सकते हो, लॉकडाउन में चलो आपका ये फ्लाइट भी बंद है, तो व्हाट कैन बी अनदर ऑप्शन टू रीच टू कुतुब मीनार फ्रॉम एलएमसीपी? द ऑप्शन कैन बी लेट अस आइडेंटिफाई न्यू वे टू रीच टू कुतुब मीनार, अंडरग्राउंड होके चलो चलते हैं। जैसे आपने महाभारत की कथा तो सुनी होगी, एट दैट टाइम those five Pandavas, to escape from the Lakshagra, they have developed some underground way to escape from the burning their Taj, the burning Mahal, palace. Okay, so this can be another way. So similarly, microorganisms, if you inhibit, so whatever the pathway, aap isoniazid le lo, rifampicin le lo, ethambutol le lo, pyrazinamide le lo, or this streptomyces. ये पांच ड्रग्स आर एक्टिंग ऑन स्पेसिफिक फाइव पाथवेज, फाइव एंजाइम्स और फाइव वेज, देन माइकोबैक्टीरियम विल डेवलप द सिक्स्थ वे टू एस्केप फ्रॉम दिस फाइव पीपल। ऑनलाइन एग्जामिनेशन में आप करते हो ना कि कभी चोरी करते हो किसी का, हाउ मेनी नो वेज वी विल ट्राई टू रिस्ट्रिक्ट द, कितना भी कायदा कानून बना लो फिर भी पीपल विल मेक द ब्लडी थिंग्स, राइट? To escape from the laws or the rules or regulations. Same thing is for microorganisms as well. And it develops the resistance. Even if we block five different paths, it will develop sixth path to meet the cellular needs in the terms of various cofactors, mediators, the chemicals, etc. Biochemicals, mycobacterium tuberculosis. Say genome is much complex, that's why chances of development of resistance are higher. So this second line NTTB drugs, the first and foremost is D-cycloserine. This is not L-cycloserine, this is capital D-cycloserine, which is a bacteriostatic. I mean to say, it is not going to kill Mycobacterium tuberculosis, but the growth of Mycobacterium tuberculosis will be stopped. This is the structure of this, and it is D-alanine alanog. If you refer to the alanine moiety, alanine amino acid, so ye alanine amino acid hi hai, but uska ek cycloserine is a cyclic structure of this D-alanine analog, and it can undergo amide, aminol, iminol tautomerism. ये जो एनएच का प्रोटॉन है ना, दैट मे शिफ्ट टू दिस कार्बोनाइल ऑक्सीजन एंड कैन प्रोड्यूस ओएच। इट विल इंटरफियर द सेल वॉल सिंथेसिस एंड कैन कॉज दिस साइड इफेक्ट्स। द मेजर साइड इफेक्ट इज नेफ्रोटॉक्सिसिटी एंड पेशेंट कैन लॉस द फंक्शनिंग ऑफ द लीवर, दैट मे बी लॉस्ट इफ दिस ड्रग इज गिवन। अनदर ड्रग आफ्टर दिस साइक्लोसेरीन विच इज डीएलएनिन एनालॉग, this ethionamide, that is another drug having pyridine moiety into its structure. But the isoniazid ke jaisa hi structure hai, but isoniazid ke case mein it was carboxamide, it was amide. Here it is thiamide, sulfur oxygen carb CONH2 ka jo oxygen hai, that is replaced by sulfur. Let me tell you, oxygen and sulfur belongs to the same row of periodic table. Sorry, same column of the periodic table. ऑक्सीजन जो जिस कॉलम में है उसी कॉलम में सल्फर एग्जैक्टली उसके नीचे है. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस दिस सल्फर इज बायो आइसोस्टर ऑफ दिस अमाइड. कार्बोक्सामाइड का बायो आइसोस्टर दैट इज थायामाइड एंड दैट इज हैविंग इथाइल एट सेकंड पोजीशन ऑफ द पिरिडीन रिंग. सिमिलर स्ट्रक्चर इज साइड आइसोनियाजाइड बट इट कैन कॉज साइड दिस psychosis and hepatitis, inflammation of liver. Okay, sorry, this is not the structure of para-aminosalicylic acid, but you know the salicylic acid. Salibenzene ring at the second position, it is OH. At the first position OH, second position COOH, and the fourth position is this NH2, para-aminosalicylic acid, which is called as PAS. Abbreviated as PAS, para amino salicylic acid, and it is going to inhibit folic acid synthase enzyme. You have visited this para amino salicylic acid during folic acid pathway. That is also inhibiting this folate synthase enzyme in Mycobacterium tuberculosis, but it can also cause such side effects, hypothyroidism, hepatitis, etc., etc. Major side effect is it can cause this megaloblastic anemia, deficiency of vitamin B9, folic acid can cause megaloblastic anemia. Anemia is basically a disorder where this blood malformation may occur because of the decreased content of some cellular content of the blood, which is a one kind of connective tissue of our body. Fluoroquinolones, this popular drug under second line NTTP drug is ciprofloxacin. Dr. Suresh, I don't remember, I don't know as well that perhaps sir has started this fluoroquinolones or not. But ciprofloxacin is, this is one of the fluoroquinolones, is used as this NTTP drug under second line category. Ofloxacin, levofloxacin are also having some more or less similar actions against microbacteria. And this is their structure. Quinoline ring having cyclopropyl at the first position of quinoline. And this is basically this is quinolone, okay, which is having this oxygen ketone at the fourth position of this. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, the sixth position of this fluorine, sixth position of this quinolone that possesses fluorine. That's why it is termed as fluoroquinolones. And basically, as you people know, they are going to inhibit the enzyme DNA gyrase, or also called as topoisomerase 2, topo 2 inhibitors. Right? Amikacin, this is another aminoglycoside antibiotic. And definitely, it is a second choice after streptomycin or capreomycin. We will also visit capreomycin in the some of the slides. That is also one of the NTTP drug, and it is used in disseminated this Mycobacterium avium cellular complex. So it is also aminoglycoside antibiotic. And side effects, moment you hear the word aminoglycoside, refer that it can cause ototoxicity and nephrotoxicity. Okay, so these are the in second line NTTP drug. Linezolid. So this is a new molecule which is in treatment of tuberculosis. Although linezolid is antibacterial agent, but it's some of the use have been identified for use as NTTP drug. So you can see the structure of this linezolid, and this moiety which is present, five-membered cyclic ring having nitrogen and oxygen. So this azahetrocycle or oxahetrocycle, that is termed as oxazolidinone. Oxazolidinone is the name of this five-membered heterocyclic ring, and the name of this drug is called linezolid. and that is having this six membered cyclic ring having oxygen and nitrogen at 1/4 position. That 1/4 position is morpholine. So iska naam jo hai na six membered ring, that is morpholine. This morpholine, when it is conjugated with this linezolide, so that morpholine is called as linezolide, and that is having a stereo center. As you can see, there is one stereo center which is there, but this is a specific isomer. So this specific isomer of linezolide is more effective than the other one. So this isomer is used as anti-TB drug. It is having 100% oral bioavailability, available in the form of tablets. The side effect is that it can cause reversible bone marrow suppression and peripheral neuropathy. Yahan par, we need to understand the things for difference between whenever an anti-TB drug, or originally this linezolide is antibacterial drug. Here it is also used for TB. So the question is, anti-TB drug, antibacterial linezolide ka jo mechanism of action hai, is it same as that of anti-TB drug? Matlab, antibacterial drug ka jo mechanism of action hai, linezolide ka, kya wo TB mein bhi wahi mechanism hai? People have given a lot of search on this. Yes, this drug is having the similar mechanism of action as that of another anti-TB drug. So we have published one review article in 2015 on oxazolidinones as anti-tubercular agents. You can refer that article if you want to go through further. Otherwise, for your PharmD knowledge, this is okay up to here, that this molecule is having similar mechanism of action as anti-TB drug, and it is acting on some of this ribosomes, some 30S or 50S ribosomes, which is present in mycobacteria. So that is similarly action is shown on mycobacterium tuberculosis. Further information you can identify from this review article published in Current Medicinal Chemistry in the year 2015, 5 years before then today. Now let us look to these are all the first line anti-TB drugs and second line anti-TB drugs. We have visited their structures, their side effects, or some mechanisms. For isoniazide and this ethambutol, we visited their metabolism and synthesis also. Now, what are the recently approved anti-TB drugs? So as I have told you, there were not a single drug which was approved by US FDA in 2012. 2005 mein sabse pehle this molecule was reported in one of the research paper of Science Journal. That name of this molecule is bedaquiline. Us time pe code diya tha TMC207. And later on, Johnson & Johnson and one another company, TB Alliance, they have developed this molecule. They took up this molecule and made it as anti-TB drug. And that drug is having minimum inhibitory concentration, which is represented in, let us say, nanogram, 4 nanogram per ml. So that was a big achievement. And uske baad, 7 saal ke baad, 2012 ke December mein, this drug was approved by US FDA to treat multi-drug resistant tuberculosis in MDR-TB patients, bedaquiline. Okay, so the similar molecule, uska hi competitive molecule is this OPC-67683, uska naam hai delaminide. This is basically quinoline derivative. You can see this is a quinoline ring which is present here, and this is naphthalene ring. So, इसलिए कभी कभी और यहाँ पे एक बेंजीन रिंग भी है, तो उसको कभी कभी बाय अराइल क्विनोलिन भी बोलते हैं, इस बेडाक्विलिन को. दिस इज अप्रूव्ड बाय USFDA और उसका ही USFDA का कॉम्पिटिटिव पार्टनर यूरोपियन मेडिकल एजेंसी EMEA दैट हैज डेवलप्ड दिस मॉलिक्यूल इन द ईयर 2013 ऑल्दो इट वॉज फर्स्ट रिपोर्टेड इन 2006 और उसका भी एक्टिविटी अप्रोक्सीमेटली 0.006 माइक्रोग्राम पर ml था या 6 नैनोग्राम पर ml बोथ आर सेम नेम ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल इज टेलामिनाइड एंड दैट इज नाइट्रोइमिडाजोल डेरिवेटिव नाइट्रोइमिडाजोल रिंग इज प्रेजेंट इन टू दिस 5 मेंबर रिंग हैविंग 1,3 डाई एज अ पोजीशन दैट इज कॉल्ड इमिडाजोल एंड दिस इमिडाजोल इज बेसिकली दिस the ring which is present in telaminide this is also nitroimidazole derivative but fark itna hai ki iske baju wala jo cycle hai wo 5 membered hai 1 2 3 4 5 aur is case mein jo 5 membered ring nahi hai wo 6 membered ring hai aur uska naam hai pretominide this molecule was discovered for the first time in 2000 in the year 2000 and last year in august 2019 Pretominide was discovered, was approved by again USFDA for the treatment of resistant tuberculosis in the children. Pretominide. This drug acts on ATP synthase inhibition. इसके बारे में अभी मुझे पता नहीं है. And this drug inhibits nitric oxide synthase enzyme. I mean NOS. And this is the list. These are the three drugs which have been approved by USFDA as well as European Medical Agency. Recently approved. This you will not find any textbook. You will find them in some of the research or review articles. Latest research or review articles. And some other molecules such as BTZ043, Q203, SQ109. So they are in clinical trial. Against tuberculosis and all of these molecules you can see they are having activity in nanogram this is 0.001 microgram per ml uska matlab hota hai 1 nanogram iska hai 2.7 nanomolar and this is also parallelly from one of that this is some thiazine on derivative this is basically imidazopyridine ring is present in this structure this is adamantyl ring do not need to remember the structures but remember their scaffold bedaquiline that is having pinoline delaminide having nitroimidazole in pretominide as well this is benzothiazinone thiazinone this is imidazopyridine and here it is adamantyl amine okay so all these are the recently approved NTTB drugs and for the first time when they have been reported those are all the molecules have been reported in the 21st century okay so these are the recently approved drugs which I could discuss with you apart from your curriculum So with this, we will stop here ourselves, and here is the end of your chapter, NTTB subchapters, NTTB drugs. So with this, thank you everyone. Thank you so much.